मैडम थैंक यू आई स्टैंड टू अपोज द प्रेजेंट एड्रेस मैडम इन द प्रेजेंट एड्रेस द प्रेजिडेंट टॉक्ट अबाउट डिग्निटी ऑफ मुस्लिम वुमेन हैव रिमेन्ड कैप्टिव टू पोलिटिकल कॉज बेनिफिट मैडम आई टेक स्ट्रांग ऑफेंस टू इट एंड आई लाइक टू कंडेम सच अ स्टेटमेंट विच नथिंग बट क्लियरली शोज द hatred which this government has for the religion of those of Indians who are 14% of the population. Madam, patriarchy is the main cause of discrimination against women. What Muslim women require are jobs and education. What this government is focusing on is only for 0.01% of Muslim women who get triple talaq. Why aren't they talking about education and jobs? And moreover, these Muslim women are require education and job, but their sons and husbands are also jobless. Madam, your remedy is worse than the disease. This new law, if it becomes a new law, God forbid, will destroy forever the Muslim marriages. You will have more Muslim men in jail and you have Muslim women on the road. Madam, what we require in India is an egalitarian society, which we have more substantive equality rather than formal equality. I want to know from the government, if they are so interested for Muslim women equality, would they give 7% reservation to Muslim women education? Would they give land ownership rights to women general in India? Let them show how sincere they are. Madam, the present address talked about 45 lakh scholarship. 2016 and 17, madam, budget, 26% budget was reduced. Third point, madam, the government said that we will give Hajj subsidy, remove fine. Where has that amount been shown? That amount is not to be shown. And moreover, madam, the pre-matric scholarship which a minority candidate gets is 1,000 rupees. Why haven't you revised it? Who has stopped you? And madam, All India Education Survey of Higher Education in 16-17 report has come. There are 3.5 crore students enrolled in higher education. Out of that, only 17.3 are Muslims, which is 4.87%. That is why we had demanded give scholarship demand driven. You have put a number on it. Same report says that there are only 4.84 Muslim teachers. This in itself clearly shows that how hollow and how hypocrite this government is, madam. Madam, you're coming to the general budget, madam. The total allocation is 4,900 crores. That is not even 0.19%. Minorities of the country are 22%. Again, it exposes that you only rely on jumlas. Madam, you talk about about one more scheme, Hunar, Ustad, Sikho Kamao. 43,182 trainees have been given placements. Not a single record is in public domain, which clearly shows that all your claims are bogus, madam. Madam, public sector lending. The Niti Aayog says that out of minority Muslim share in minorities is for 73%. My priority sector lending share is only 45%. What have you done? Again, you are in power 4 years. This again shows how hollow and shallow your claims are. Madam, pre-matric scholarship, post-matric, merit come means, it has been reduced since this government came into power. It is not my figures. These are your figures, madam. Scholarship amounts to minorities have come down drastically since this government came into power. The Prime Minister talks about empowerment of Muslims. Madam, not a single meeting the Prime Minister has taken as a Prime Minister, and he has not shared the 15-point program. 15-point program in 4 years. Main malum karna chahta hoon ki Wazir Azam ne ek meeting nahi li. 15 nikati Wazir Azam program ki ek meeting nahi liya. Aur aap bade bade baatein karte hain. Aur 6 mahine mein ek martaba meeting honi chahiye. Kabhi nahi hui meeting. Ye pura data hai, madam. Aur madam, aakhir mein main apni baat khatam karne se pehle, government ne sahi kaha ki Baba Sahib Ambedkar ne kaha tha ki siyasi jamhooriyat ki baqa या सियासी जमहूरियत उस वक्त ही जिंदा रह सकती है जब समाजी और माशी जमहूरियत का फायदा होगा. मैडम, मैं हुकूमत से जानना चाह रहा हूं कि इस मुल्क को आजाद होकर 70 साल का एक लंबा अरसा हो चुका है, और खास तौर से यह सरकार आने के बाद हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, हमारे आईन में जो लिबर्टी, फ्रेटर्निटी, इक्वालिटी, जस्टिस की बात की गई है, आपने तो उन तमाम चीजों को कमजोर किया. मैं हुकूमत से जानना चाहता हूं कि क्या आप बाबा साहब अंबेडकर जो कहा था कि सियासी जमहूरियत उस वक्त तक पनप नहीं सकती जब तक समाजी और माशी डेमोक्रेसी नहीं मिलेगी. मैं तल हकीकत आपके सामने बयान कर रहा हूं, मैडम, मैं खत्म कर रहा हूं. आज भी 70 साल के बाद मुझे पाकिस्तानी कहकर पुकारा जाता है। क्यों मैडम? ये मैंने जिन्ना के पैगाम को ठुकराया हर जगह पर मैडम। अब तो हम तिरंगा भी नहीं लहरा सकते। मैं हुकूमत से पूछना चाहता हूं कि क्या आप ऐसा कानून बनाएंगे, ऐसा कानून बनाइए जिस तरह SC ST को बनाया गया कि जो कोई भी हिंदुस्तान में किसी मुसलमान को पाकिस्तानी पुकारेगा उसको नॉन बेलेबल बनाएंगे। क्योंकि 153 फेल हो चुका है। 153 देखिए मैडम, चीख मार रहे, देखिए देखिए देखिए, यही है इनका रवैया, यही है इनका रवैया, जिससे जाहिर होता है इनकी सोच और इनकी नीयत। मैं आपसे कह रहा हूं कि जिन्ना के पैगाम को हमने ठुकराया। आप क्या कानून बना सकते कि हिंदुस्तान में किसी भी मुसलमान को कोई पाकिस्तानी नहीं पुकारेगा? आप बनाइए उसको, 3 साल सजा दीजिए, मगर आप नहीं बनाएंगे। आप कानून जो ट्रिपल तलाक बनाने जा रहे हैं, ये औरतों के खिलाफ है, मुसलमानों के खिलाफ है, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के खिलाफ है। इससे औरतों से